Here I have a small scene in Blender. The scene is lit with one sunlight. Scene download link in the description. And with a sky texture. I'm using Eevee render engine with an ambient occlusion applied. Let's start by creating a gradient texture. I will be using Affinity Photo for that. You can use any other image editing software which allows you to create gradients. First, create a new image texture. Since our scene will only use a few gradient colors, 64 by 64 is more than enough. I'm using the rectangle tool to divide the texture into 5 parts. I'm changing the color so it's easier to see separated parts. Here I have 5 blocks for 5 different gradients. I accidentally hide the last layer behind, which I will unhide later on. The first block will be a wood gradient. Select the gradient tool. Choose a wood color. And add a gradient from the top to the bottom. Select and change the bottom color to a little different shade. Colors I have used. Export texture as PNG. I will call it scene_texture. Back to the Blender. Open the UV editing workspace. Select the log. And create a new material, scene. Enable material preview viewport shading so we can see our material changes, and set roughness to 1 to make it more flat and clean look. Apply image texture and open our gradient texture. Now we have a texture applied to the log. Slash to isolate the selection. Switch to the side view of the log. Tap to enter the edit mode. View project from view. We have unwrapped the log from view. Let's open our gradient texture inside the UV editor to see what we are doing. And scale down the log UV island to fill the wood gradient color. S, Y to scale by Y axis. S, X to scale by X axis. Make sure to leave a gap around the UV island so that the pixels won't bleed from one gradient to the other. Now we have a nice gradient going from the dark bottom to the light top. Let's improve it a bit. Enable face select. Select front and the back faces. Switch to the front or back view. View project from view. Scale down the UV island and move it on top of the light color. Now the log has nice highlights. Slash to quit isolated mode. Change to the renderer viewport shading to see how it looks with a nice lighting. The log is done. Let's create a gradient for mushrooms. I will use the second block for mushrooms. Export and overwrite our scene texture PNG. Back to Blender. Alt-R inside the UV editor to refresh the texture changes. Select all three mushrooms. And then select the log last. Ctrl-L, materials. To apply the log material scene to all mushrooms. Now select any mushroom, tab to enter the edit mode, Alt-A to deselect, L to select the whole top part, U project from view, and scale it to fit the gradient. Do the same with the other part. The mushroom is looking good. Since all of the mushrooms are the same duplicated mesh, we can quickly transfer UV map from unwrapped mesh to other two. First, select two mushrooms without the UV map, and then select the one with UV map. Ctrl-L, transform UV maps. Now all mushrooms have the same UV map. Let's continue by texturing rocks. I will be using the third block for rocks gradient. Let's set the color to light gray with a little shade of blue. Add a gradient. The second color will be a darker gray-blue. Save the texture changes. Alt-R inside the UV editor to refresh the texture changes. Apply the same scene material to all three rocks. Select any rock, change to the front view camera, unwrap from view, scale the UV island to match the gradient, and transfer UV map to other rocks. Let's continue by texturing fir trees. I will unhide the fifth layer block, which I hide at the beginning accidentally. Let's use the fourth block for fir trees. I set yellow green as a base color, add gradient, and green blue as a second color. I think these two colors go very well together. Save the texture changes. Refresh the texture changes in Blender. Apply the scene material to both fir trees. Select one fir tree. Slash to isolate the mesh. Let's change to the material preview viewport shading to see the mesh better. Tap for edit mode. Alt-A to deselect all faces. Switch to the side view, wireframe view. Select all top faces. U, project from view. Scale the UV island to match the gradient. enable material preview to see a texture. Looking good. Now do the same with the middle part. R and type 180 to rotate the UV island by 180 degrees. Now the outside is the light color and the inside is the darker color. Do the same with the bottom part. Select the tree trunk, unwrap from view, and move it on top of the wood color. Fir tree is done. Slash to exit the isolated view, transfer fir tree UV map to the other fir tree. Assets are looking lovely. Let's texture the ground mesh. Add a gradient and change it to radial. Reverse gradient and slide the midpoint to the side to make the circle sharper. Change the black color to green-yellow color. Save texture changes. Refresh the texture, apply the scene material to the ground, tap for the edit mode, A to select all faces, U, unwrap. Scale down the UV island to fit the gradient. We are almost done. To make it even better, we can add some moss to the places where assets intersect with the ground. With a gradient tool selected, press on the middle of the gradient line to add a new color point. Select the bottom point and change the color to the ground green. Now we have a nice mossy wood gradient. Let's do the same with a rock gradient. And here we have a nice moss gradient on the wood and rock assets. This way, assets look more grounded. You can easily control how much of the moss you want to apply by editing the UV map. That's it. Gradient texturing is done. This is a very simple, nice looking and efficient way of texturing game assets for mobile devices. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more.